Microlecture 25, The Scramble for Africa. After the abolition of slavery in the Atlantic, the history of the African continent changed. Islam continued its advance in the continent, expanding south of the Saharan Desert. Europeans began to intervene politically in the continent after 1880, when powers such as France, England, and Belgium recognized the economic potential that the region had. Before the Europeans began their colonialism, the most crucial development in West Africa was the economic change after the decline of the Atlantic trade. With the slavery gone, other African commodities like palm oil became profitable. Palm oil developed into an essential commodity because the product was useful for the industrialization of Europe. Palm oil sales surged in the second half of the 19th century with a significant increase in the number of tons sold each year. Manufacturers used palm oil to lubricate their dyeing new machines, make soap, and other cosmetics. Another African product that rapidly popularized and made a lot of money was peanuts, which American and European markets began to consume greatly. Since the slave markets were not as profitable as before, African labor began to be used to produce legitimate goods for world markets. Groups of African merchants formed to control the new trade networks. In this business scheme, women play a vital role as administrators, negotiators, and translators. By the 1850s and 1860s, a new class of African merchants had emerged, especially in the western part of the continent. Rapidly, these people began to educate themselves in the West. A class of African lawyers, teachers, journalists, intellectuals, and thinkers quickly developed. Between 1880 and 1914, several European powers like Britain, France, Germany, Belgium, Spain, Portugal, and Italy worried that they, in the words of Belgian King Leopold II, will not get a piece of the African cake. As a consequence, these imperial powers decisively scrambled for African possessions. In 1880, Europeans controlled barely 20% of the African continent. In 1914, they held 90% and had moved from the coastal areas to the interior. Only two African territories remain independent, Ethiopia and Liberia. In the consolidation of European imperialism in Africa, several historical factors and individuals play a definitive role. For example, missionaries play an important role in promoting the idea that the European conquest and colonization of the continent was going to end the human tragedy of slavery and exploitation by bringing, in the words of famous Scottish missionary David Livingstone, commerce, Christianity, and civilization to Africa. One individual who played a crucial role in Africa's scramble was the powerful King of Belgium, Leopold II, 1865-1909. Leopold was the architect behind the continent's colonization, starting by his country's enterprise along the Congo River. Leopold promised to promote Christianity and civilization in the new states. As a result of these people's interventions, by 1883, Europe had cut the, quote, African fever, unquote, and the competition for the continent's control was going full steam. To make the competition fairer for the European states, the French Premier Jules Ferry and the German Chancellor Otto von Bismarck arranged a European Conference on Sub-Saharan Africa in Berlin during 1884 and 1885. The Berlin Conference, which did not have in attendance any Africans, established the principle that European claims to African territory had to rest on the idea of, quote, effective occupation, unquote, to be recognized by other states. A nation could establish a colony only if it had effectively taken possession of the territory through signed treaties with local leaders and had agreed to develop it economically. At the conference, the representatives recognized Leopold's rule over the Congo Free State in compensation for his labor. Containing the General Act of the Conference, the rules for imperialist competition signed in Berlin also include agreements to take care of native people by providing moral and material goods, promoting Christianity, suppressing slavery, and developing civilization and progress. In any case, the conference's main goal was to promote commerce and the exploitation of African resources. The conference coincided with many historical processes in Europe. First was Germany's emergence as an imperial power under the leadership of Otto von Bismarck. The country formed many protectorates to administer small African kingdoms and societies. A protectorate is an autonomous territory partially controlled and protected by a stronger outside power. Another important process was France's expansion into West Africa. Equally important was the British move from South Africa to the east of the continent. At this time, the British also gained control of Egypt and tried to extend south, but were stopped by the Sudanese. In 1898, using machine guns for the first time, the British won in the Battle of Omdurman. 11,000 Sudanese were killed. Only 28 Britons died that day. All the European imperial powers used violence to defend their colonial possessions. It was their way of retaining control, subdue the population, appropriate land, and forcing African laborers to work long hours at physically demanding and dangerous jobs. The paradigmatic example of European violence in Africa is that of the Congo Free State, dominated by the Belgians. There, the reign of Leopold II imposed the most brutal living conditions on the whole continent. The brutality and exploitation were so intense that many human rights activists denounced it. In South Africa, the conditions were different because many whites settled there, and a strong capitalist economy was developed. Since the 1800s, this area of Africa was disputed by the British, the Afrikaners, who were descendants of the Dutch, and the native populations. South Africa was a prosperous territory, and after the discovery of deposits of diamonds in 1867 and gold in 1886, the conflicts were exacerbated. The mining boom contributed to the arrival of the British imperialists. Perhaps the most famous of all was Cecil Rhodes. He even created a country called Rhodesia, modern-day Zimbabwe and Zambia. In 1899, the conflict between the British imperialists and the Afrikaners sparked the South African War. The three-year conflict between whites was brutal and has often been considered the first total war. After the conflict, the biggest losers were the black South Africans who suffered the impositions of a segregated society that later became known as the apartheid. By 1900, most of the African continent was in the hands of Europeans. They exploited all the economic resources available and destroyed all visible traces of traditional culture. These colonial governments also show little interest in providing essential social services to the black populations, and as a consequence, these territories remain underdeveloped for decades. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.